bit passionate, so yeah, we always have good games, quality games, and then I think it's not going to be different today.
You had to dig quite deep, didn't you, Kim, to get past that your last encounter?
Yeah, indeed. Joe played amazing darts. I have to say that. Respect for him. His finishes were amazing, especially in the beginning of the game. And yeah, he had me go all the way, so yeah, respect.
And Chuck, it's been a little bit more serene, your progress to this point so far. Would you have liked a sort of a bigger test, the likes of Kim just had?
Well, I don't know. I think Benito and Michael Smith are pretty big tests in themselves. You know, they've both been on good form the last two seasons, and you know, I'm quite happy. It's just been, you know, I mean, the Michael game, that was just a bit weird. I think 12 breaks a throw in the match, but you know, progress is there. It's, you know, it's all about today now.
Huge incentive, isn't it, for both of you? I mean, you know, into the finals day in a semi-final, just one match away now.
Yeah, it's yeah, like I said, it's all on the day. So hopefully a good, steady day today, and you know, we'll do well.
And does this feel a bit different for both of you? I mean, the absence of the big names, it gets talked about, but it must be a factor in the back of your minds. This is a major opportunity for someone just to come and snatch a major title here.
I think there are eight players now that are thinking like that. It's for everyone a major opportunity. But then again, we know we can beat these guys as well. They're really good, but we are good as well on the day. They just do it a bit more often than us. But, well, do we have to look at it? No. We're in a quarterfinal. We deserve it. And unlucky, whether it's due to an injury or just a loss, but we're here and we deserve it.
You agree with that, Chuck? Does it, in a weird way, does it add a bit more pressure because it's such an opening for other players to emerge?
Well, I think you should just concentrate on who's here and who's in the tournament. Who's not here, it doesn't really matter, you know. That's the way I look at it, you know. It's, you know, you can say it's a bonus. It was only a bonus if you drew Michael, because then you didn't have to play.
Christo?
All right, listen, both of you, good luck.
Thank you.
Okay, cheers.
Hey, warm welcome. You've joined us live on ITV Sport from Butlins Minehead! And the quarterfinal stages of the Coral UK Open, that's brought to you by the Professional Darts Corporation. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's time now to meet the quarterfinalists. Would you please welcome the German Darts Champion and a winner of three PDQ ranking events, ladies and gentlemen, Alan Chuck And now, ladies and gentlemen, a World Cup finalist, a World Championship quarter-finalist, the winner of four PDC ranking events from Belgium, the Hurricanes, Kim
us this afternoon. How do you top that waistcoat from yesterday? John Rawley is a little bit more soberly attired today. He's in the company of the always sober, honestly, Alan Warren a little.
It's Sunday, Jackie. You've got to give due respect and make yourself look smart, eh, Alan?
Absolutely. Straight
from
church.
Got some good matches, haven't we, today? The really, really well-matched games, and this is going to be one right out of that bracket.
Yeah, we mentioned at the top of the show that every one of the eight players will genuinely believe they've got a chance of lifting that trophy at the end of the day.
Alan Norris quoted at 12-1 to win this title at this stage. He's looked good this weekend, but the marginal favourite to win this match is Kim Huybrechts, 9-1 to win the title.
Hi, ladies and gentlemen.
And he's had the highest average in that fourth round match against Ted Evarts, averaged 110.29 in thrashing Evarts 10-1. As ever, both these guys will be absolutely intent on getting out of the blocks flying, making a fast start.
Yeah, absolutely. The Hurricane was almost blown away in the last round, but a last leg win over Cullen kept his title hopes alive.
Good match, wasn't it?
Well, Norris has been the maximum man. 15 maximums in the last two games against Michael Smith and Van der Pass. And that's been a real big feature of him getting to the quarters.
Couple of sing-along classics that they came into. 100. Frankie Valli and Jeff Beck, the crowd enjoying them. There's Ronnie Huybrechts, another good player. Kim's older brother watching on.
139.
I'm sure Dana, Kim's partner, here to watch this, but no doubt if she's not, she'll be keeping a very close eye on things from back home.
81. Alan Yurikar, 167.
First finish for Norris. Through first in this leg.
93.
Nothing wrong with that. Slow start here from Huybrechts.
40. Alan, you require 74.
So 74 for Alan Norris for the first leg of the match. 20 would leave tops. Here we go. How good is his aim? Excellent.
Nice steady 15 dart leg on throw. That'll certainly settle him down very, very quickly. Kim yet to find his range. I know we're only in the start of the second leg.
Used to, of course, the players, what it takes to prepare. They'll have been here for an hour or two in the practice room before they get up there on the stage. And I heard Chris speaking and yourself, Alan, about the fact that it is physically demanding, isn't it, to potentially have three matches in one day. And Raymond van Barneveld, is he going to be able to put something together of that sort of intensity? You know, you'd think in the way he's playing, yeah, great chance, but is he going to be able to put three matches together back to back? And that's a really valid question.
Yeah, it's a big part of the mental game, isn't it? Because 59. You've got to get yourself really psyched up and ready for your first match. You come down again and you've got to get yourself back up. It's really difficult to do.
Yeah, this is match play rather than you're not just going and doing the 12 legs maximum that you get in a Premier League match. This is a much more physically demanding test.
Yeah, your thoughts have to be on the match that you're playing in. You've also got to have something in the back of your mind looking towards the semis and possibly the final.
167.
Kim needs to wake up pretty rapidly here, because Norris is putting himself onto a nice setup and Huybrechts is not on a finish.
102.
Oh, very slow start from Kim, which is surprising. He's normally out of the blocks very quickly. Still a long way to go though, but you don't want to get too far behind.
You require 65.
First to 10. Taking a place in the last four. Tops then for Norris for 2-0.
45.
Huybrechts breathes again.
118.
Oh, hasn't got his scoring boots on, but if he can just nick this one here. Always hit it. Double 19 for 118. Oh,
80.
Big chance there.
Well, that would have been a steal, wouldn't it? 4-3 the record in PDC meetings in Alan Norris's favour. And there he goes, 2-0.
Alan Norris.
First televised meeting since, I think, the 2014 Grand Slam, when Kim Huybrechts won 10-5 on the way to the semi-finals of that particular event. Met four times last year, and it was two apiece.
Well, they'll certainly both be wary that they know what the other opponent can do.
139.
They also know It's a big, big chance for both players to progress in this tournament. And the rewards that you get.
Huybrechts ranked 13th by the PDC. Alan Norris 17th.
Yeah, not too much between them on the rankings. Well, that's better.
First maximum of the match going Huybrechts way. The man from Antwerp in Belgium.
91. He was fabulous in that win against Ted Everts, wasn't he? 110 average. Absolutely good, incredible over in the Reds bar on board two.
130.
Oh, good.
I commentated on that match against Joe Cullen last night, and it was, you got the impression it was just that little bit of, it was a nip and tuck sort of match, 96. Obviously, but the experience of Huybrechts, while he wasn't playing brilliantly, kind of helped get him across the line.
Yeah, it's important when you're not playing that well to just sometimes take those little chances that 20. You can get.
And you require 74.
Didn't do there though.
Right, 74 then for Norris. Went for this in the first leg, didn't he? Now let's see if he can get it out this time. 74 required. Double 16. Important dart. Oh, he's 42. Blown it. Huybrechts now can nick the leg.
42. He'd be mad at himself there, Norris. Because he really would have kept the pressure on Kim Huybrechts. 3-0. 2-1 is a totally different game.
Kim Huybrechts won the last time they met, their most recent meeting, which was in the European Grand Prix in Sindelfingen. Won it by 6-2. Nice to see Elton John here.
135.
Just starting to find his range now, Kim Huybrechts.
Took him a while to settle, didn't he? But he's moving up a gear now. Good crowd. It is a complete sellout, of course, but sometimes, for reasons which you don't really need to me to elaborate on too much, it can be a little bit restrained in the early stages. But there's a lot made their way in here for the start of play, filling towards its 5,000 capacity. Tremendous darting arena this is. All the players going through their preparations, the crowds as well. Many of them in their fancy dress, travelling from all over the world to be here. Right, this to square up the match. Treble 17. No.
He can't do it. Norris is back on 151, so he's got all work to do here. So the leg. Is it the treble? It's not treble 20 in tops. Tops are 151.
111. Can you require 68?
Double 16 after the treble 12. Oh, that's nice finishing. That'll put him into a better frame of mind. And you can see how much he thought of that as he turned and celebrated, looked out to the VIP area where his brother, Ronnie, is sitting.
Yeah, we're feeling pretty good now.
96.
He's found his range. He's back level. Could have been much worse.
And two apiece with the first break of the match coming up at the end of this leg. And if Huybrechts could nick a leg here, then he would be delighted with the outcome of that opening session.
60.
And he's just got a bit of a squeak now after that visit.
Yeah, starting to put the dart, the first dart above the treble.
60.
Didn't quite get one there, but he's given himself more of a chance of getting the big scores.
93.
Handy last dart, needed it, but the throw is under pressure.
Will be now. He's already had one maximum. There's number two. Good timing.
And he's set himself onto 1-2-1 again, which is always one of those favoured finishes. You see a lot of attempts at checkouts coming from 121. You all know how it goes. Now he's looking at 11s. Double 14 with the treble. Oh, just wired it.
Yeah, just on the wire, but not in. So it gives an outside chance for Norris. If you can get the treble with the first dart, he needs another. He gets it. Top to 160 for Norris. He loved that one. He loved that one. Kim Huybrechts didn't. Huybrechts had the chance with a 1-2-1. Didn't quite hit the double 14. And up stepped Alan Norris with a fantastic 160 finish. He leads
3-2. Minehead, Kim Huybrechts had just missed a 1-2-1 checkout opportunity just, and then up stepped Alan Norris, 160, and that was a holder throw in a leg that he looked as though he was going to lose. So we're back here with it really nicely balanced, this match. Huybrechts will have the darts, and Alan Norris, Big Chuck, leading thanks to that checkout, the best of the match so far. He leads 3-2, Alan.
Yeah, fabulous finish there from Norris. Out of the old locker, and as you saw the look on King Hybeck's face, it was almost that look of, yeah, good shot, and something else.
Yes. 140. I think it's fair to say he was happy. Charged up.
Well, it was just at that point, wasn't it, where Norris is looking for another maximum. Hasn't hit one yet in this match, but 15 in the tournament. It was just at that point, wasn't it, where Hybeck's looked like he was getting in front, 2-0 down, got it back to 2-2, chance at the 1-2-1, just couldn't hit the double 14.
Well, you said to me during the break, Alan, and it's, you know, it's kind of always worth saying, it's one of the beauties of darts. You get these situations where it looks as though the one player's got the momentum, as Kim Huybrechts, younger brother of Ronnie, watching on there. It looks as though he's got the momentum, but just one moment, that brilliant checkout, suddenly a very emphatic change of impetus.
Yeah, it changes everything, doesn't it, so quickly. That's why we say it can, you can be in front or you can be behind, but the game can change so quickly.
174.
Great 174 there, three big trebles.
Good as a maximum, sets it up for potentially an 11 darter for Norris, and there's a third maximum for Huybrechts. So can Chuck do this?
17 for Bull. He went for the treble, but it's the ball.
67. Oh,
Kim had a good lie with the first dart.
Yeah, he fancied that, didn't he? 60. Gets it for double 10. And that is quality finishing. Holds his throw. He was under pressure.
Yeah, and they're both starting to get a little bit of aggression in the game, in the sense of when they do
85.
Hit that winning double in the leg. They like to have that release to the crowd.
59.
Norris again. Just scoring slightly the heavier.
140.
Well, we said at the start, didn't we, John? 15 maximums in his last two games. It has been a big feature.
93.
And there's another one. First of this match. Boosting his average close to 106.
Back comes Huybrechts. But he can't leave the finish.
76 now. Is that in? He is. Double 8.
80.
No checkout for Huybrechts, so Norris will get another go to hold 57. His throw.
Alan, you require 16.
It's not put a great deal of pressure on. Double 8. Here we go. And it is. Again, throw successfully held.
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely. Well, that's number 5. For Huybrechts. It took him a couple of legs to get going, but since then, he's got up to the level he needs to be at.
And it's developing into a good match, this. It's shaping up into what we anticipated. All good games that we're going to be having this afternoon. Hope you can stay with us. Ian White against Gerwin Price. 99. Gerwin, who accounted for Paul Hogan, the Riley qualifier yesterday. Simon Whitlock back in form against Daryl Gurney. And finishing up with the big one, Peter Wright and Raymond van Barneveld. Peter Wright, the 6-4 favourite to win this title now.
Yep, some tasty Sunday lunches there as Huybrechts hits yet another maximum. That's six!
Flying. And looking for an 11 darter.
132, Kim require 42.
Looking for 10 with his first darts, which he gets for double 16. And four all, 11 darts, quality.
Excellent darts from Kim Huybrechts, and that's five maximums as well in the last four legs. Brilliant darts from both players at the moment.
There's six maximums there.
Yeah, incredible. Both averaging well into the hundreds at this moment in time.
96.
Looking good.
Yeah, first to 10. Huybrechts keeps up like this. He could be getting double figures of maximums, which is some achievement if he gets up there.
41.
The next 180 will be number 150 on the main stage this weekend. Statistics supplied courtesy of Stuart Pike.
Stato.
There it is!
Well, this is amazing from Kim Huybrechts. Six maximums in the last four and a half legs.
133.
But Norris still keeping the advantage. On his throw here. But look at this from Huybrechts. Is it another? Oh, just the wrong side of the wire.
Well, exceptional scoring from Huybrechts, and he's still behind in the leg. Treble 19 for Bull. He gets it. He needs the ball.
84. Kim require 157.
157 now. Kim Huybrechts. Alan Norris just a wee bit slow taking his darts out of the board. I'm sure it was not a deliberate ploy. Well, maybe it was.
85. Alan, you require 48.
48 then for 5-4 to hold his throw, Alan.
Trying to keep his composure, and even at this stage, it's still important. Decent marker. Couldn't quite get it underneath.
Well, this could be a very important break of throw. 16 would leave tops. Nicely done. Tops then. Norris gets away with it.
Well, both players not hitting the double top. But crucially, Norris has three more darts at that target in his sights.
Double five.
Game shall remain playing. Alan Norris.
Come on, he roars towards the crowd.
Yeah, they're both really fired up for this match, I can assure you. That release when you hit the double in an important leg. And these two don't hang about.
Ranking tournament, if Alan Norris were to actually emerge victorious here, it would put him into the top 16, which is an important statistic, as long as you're not actually at number 16, because that means that you're going to be playing Michael van Gerwen on just about every occasion you can imagine.
Yeah, still a good feat though to get in the top 16 in this day and age. The PDC is incredible standard now.
That's his second, ninth of the match.
It's not just getting in the top 16, John, either. It's everything else that comes with it. You know, maybe a place in the Grand Slam. There's also the places for the World Series up for grabs. The Invitational.
Number three. Yeah, when you get into the top 16 as well, but it's pretty self-evident. You're sort of getting yourself into the sort of ranking where you're going to be under consideration for the Premier League, which is a big lucrative earner if you manage to get there.
Absolutely. Tops.
40.
Only five doubles out of 20. Alan Norris, 150 for Huybrechts to hold his throw. Big ask, and it's proved to be too much of a task.
134.
Good setup, but again, Norris has the target in his sights. Three darts in his hand.
Break after this leg. Good marker, that one. Oh dear. Now, this is a bit important one, and he's missed it. So, Huybrechts, having been pretty much out with the washing, here he is.
Big, big opportunity for Huybrechts here. Norris was looking at 6-4. On the wire, he's moving over the hockey. Oh, he can't believe it. He can't believe it.
Somewhere on the Somerset Devon boundary when he threw that third dart. Double two for Norris. Ones, Madhouse.
No score.
Well, we've had this on a few occasions over the weekend where an incredible match has had this kind of occasion where both players have struggled to hit the double. Well, Huybrechts eventually hits the double eight. It could have been 6-4 to Norris, but the Belgian, with that stern look on his face, hits the double eight. We go into the break. Five legs apiece.
Quarter-final stage of the UK Open here in Minehead, and the next match coming up for you after this, Ian White from Stoke against the Welshman, the former professional rugby player Gerwyn Price. Tight one on paper, that one, just as this one is. Kim Huybrechts and Alan Norris, and still they're locked together, five apiece.
Yeah, Norris and Huybrechts battling out for a place in the semi-finals of the Coral UK Open. First quarter-final of this afternoon session. The crowd's building, the tension's building. Here we go.
Huybrechts was a narrow favourite when the action began. Little between them in terms of records in recent times, in rankings. Norris getting his fourth maximum. Great way to start the second session. Huybrechts has seven. Norris, who's had a fair number of nine darters around the circuit. Not going to be this time.
And he got two, didn't he, very quickly in his PDC career. Both against the same player.
Who was that against?
Can't remember who it was 60. Now, but he got one at Q School and then one at the one of the first UK qualifiers last a couple of years ago.
We'll get that piece of information, no doubt. People are tweeting us even as we speak to tell us who that was.
Huybrechts with the earplugs in. He likes to do his own thing up there. A lot of players do use the earplugs nowadays.
Alan Rupal, 130.
Huybrechts well back. Sorry, Alan.
Yeah, good thinking there from Norris. Didn't need to go for the big finish.
140.
Well, 108 Huybrechts, but Norris on tops to hold his throw, which he nicely does. Six doubles out of 26. He's been struggling a bit on his checkouts, but no problem there. 6-5.
Yeah, he's missed a few important doubles, hasn't he? Certainly that one in the 10th leg, which allowed Huybrechts to get back to five apiece. But no trouble there.
His third successful double from nine attempts at tops. See, Kim Huybrechts is wearing earplugs up there on stage 70. To block out extraneous noise. Merv King style. Barney, another one.
Yeah, quite a few players do use those nowadays. It gets so loud sometimes in the auditorium.
It's what I need when you start shouting bull.
Any bigger earplugs on that, John?
Nearly takes the top of the commentary box off. 40. Thank goodness for good soundproofing.
Down for 19s.
Everybody having their special moments here in Minehead. Will you marry me, Samantha? Of course you will. You don't need to ask. Of course you will.
57.
11 maximum so far in the match. 7 from Huybrechts. Matt's spell in the middle from Huybrechts where he hit 6 in 5 legs.
100.
Finishing hasn't been great for either man. Huybrechts at 36%, Norris at only at 23%, and Allen, if he had 64. Better checkout ratio, his match average 99, he'd be well up over a ton.
Yeah, it's been the timing as well, hasn't it? Can make such a difference.
53.
Trying to go for treble 16 with the last one.
170, the maximum possible checkout. Treble 20, treble 20, bull. Here goes Alan Norris to see if he can pull it off. There's one of them. That's two of them. Bullseye for 170. Oh, crowd wanted that one. We wanted that. You did at home, no doubt.
He would have given it the old tally-ho. He'd have hit that one, wouldn't he? Double six.
60.
Chance missed.
So the break is still a possibility for Norris. Oh, dear. He wanted the single 9, so he's got 7 left. I don't think we'd be wanting to articulate what thoughts are going through his mind now. So, 3-2. Oh, well done. That is, I tell you what, that is a good mental reset after that. He went for the fat 9, the big 9, and whacked it into double and then still managed to check out.
That roar was, well, relief, wasn't it? Because he knew he'd made a mess of the big 9. That big double 2 was massive.
59.
That was also a break of throw, which is important as we come into the latter stages of the game. First to 10, Norris now has the cushion of 2 legs.
46.
And Huybrechts, not a good start. This is a piano somewhere in the building. St. Pancras style.
44.
Well, he's enjoying himself.
Huybrechts
has got to keep going here. He doesn't want to get too far behind. 2 legs behind already in a race to 10.
140.
Could spell trouble if he loses this one.
Badly needs a treble. No.
45.
Norris is on a finish.
Very much so.
Well, it's not often you hear the shout of 162.
96 for 8-5.
Well, he has been going. Well, he looks like he's staying there. He has been going for 2 doubles, but not on that occasion.
56.
Maybe because Huybrechts was on the 130. I don't know.
This would hurt though if he took it. Good first one.
He's got to get it as well.
Yeah, it's on. Double 5. Oh, yes, 130. And that is Huybrechts right back, the break back. And what a time to get a 130 checkout.
Well, that really changes things, doesn't it? It really could have been 8-5. 7-6. Huybrechts will now know he's well and truly back in this quarter-final. It would have spelt danger if he'd have lost that leg.
Kim's one of those players who really lets his 95. Darts go, isn't he? He's a hard thrower of a dart.
Yeah, a lot of the fans like to see the emotion as well, don't they? To see what it actually means.
60. Certainly wears. Well, both of them, both these lads wear the heart on their sleeve, don't they?
Yeah, they do. They've had to give it the old back of the net 1-0.
59.
Still all to play for.
Hear the thundering in. Huybrechts really lets those darts go. Slightly more measured, rhythmic approach from Norris.
120.
Unlucky there.
Yeah, they certainly give it some force. He's not happy with that one, but he's probably going to have to stay there because he's on 260. Oh, what a lovely last dart that was. Wunderbar.
Keep 160.
Not this time. Alan Norris has had a 160.
140.
But now the break is a possibility. 90. This is a very real chance.
It's important as well. Oh, he's hit the ball. Two darts at tops. Oh, he only needed one.
Alan Norris.
Norris gets that two leg cushion again. So Huybrechts hit that 130 to get within one.
Good match. Really good match. Looking for a place in the last four semi-finals and finals 59. To be played this evening. So if you're toying with the idea of going out or watching something else, don't do it. Don't do it. Watch the darts with us on ITV4.
Absolutely, there's plenty of fire in the belly. Of these two players, there's still plenty that could happen.
Well, is Huybrechts going to be able 81. To get the immediate break back? One maximum already. Looking to fill it up for a second time.
140.
Unlucky. Five perfect darts there. A nod of disapproval from Mr. Rawling.
140.
Tin Man.
Wizard of Oz action.
60.
Well, Norris not able to put on the pressure as he would have wished.
Should really stay on the 20s here. That's why he's just checking the score.
57. Kimrukar 121.
Not much damage done. 121. Great dart. 11 now. For the bullseye. For 121.
96. Ooh,
just the wrong side of the wire by fractions he misses.
Well, he's missed the 121 on a couple of occasions and he's been punished. But he won't be this time. But he's really got to keep his focus on this 25, because it is very, very
35.
Important.
35, not the visit that Norris needed. Ooh, only just in that 9. Double 8, and he gets it. So that's the break back. Swapping blows, swapping legs, swapping breaks. And now back on throw, and Huybrechts with the darts to square it up again.
Oh, Norris keeps getting in front. Huybrechts keeps biting back, just like he did against Joe Cullen. In that last 16 match last night.
It was one of those games that I said to Kim afterwards, whoever lost, you're going to be walking off that stage thinking, the other guy's not won it, I lost it. And I'm sure Joe went off the stage 85. Thinking precisely that.
Yeah, I'm sure he did. He put a lot of effort into the match. He might just have done Kim 81. A bit of good at that time in circumstances like this.
Joe was well up at one stage in that match and lost his way. And Huybrechts, as we said earlier, the big match edge in experience, maybe used to playing up there on the big stage, and just managed to get his nose over the line. There is the nose.
140.
Great leg here from Huybrechts, looking to level. Looked like he was going to level.
134.
A couple of legs to go, but 90 finish. From Norris, ended that. But he's got a good chance here.
Six darts from 146. 99. He'd take that any day of the week, wouldn't he? And great last dart, setting up 47. Norris can do no more than try and batter the big numbers.
132.
That's a pretty good effort.
Very good effort. Huybrechts knows he has to get this. He has to get this. And he has. He knows how important that was. So does Norris.
Best of three now.
Yep. Let's see who can have that 59. Final push. Only 59 from Norris.
Bull up behind the scenes when they decide who's going to go first. Sometimes has real significance. Could be that this is one of those moments, but there is maximum number 9 for Kim Huybrechts. 13 in this match.
And you could see the concentration and the look in Kim Huybrechts as he fired in that maximum. He didn't give it any aggression. 41. Kept his composure.
Norris is in trouble. Huybrechts has got the darts by virtue of that opening 180. Could do with a treble here just to cement the advantage, and he 41. Didn't want the one, so Norris can hit back.
And he's got to hit back with a big one, and it's not happening.
60.
Bottle time, Alan.
Well, it's trying to put those thoughts of where you are, the situation you're in, at the back of your mind, and it's very hard to do.
140.
Huybrechts, 140 left after 9. Marvellous leg.
Norris needs a little bit of magic.
140. 140.
So 140 for Huybrechts.
Well, great last two darts there. Leaves himself double 12.
Norris is going to be on a finish, but now he has to walk back from the hockey, just hoping.
Big moments here. Double 12.
Yes.
Nicely done. And now with the darts, with the throw, to win the match.
Well, three legs on the spin for the Hurricane, and he's in again. He's already had 9 in the match. Number 10.
Crowd loving the maximums from the Belgian, from the Hurricane. And Norris had been trying to get a bit of the tension out of his shoulders. He needs to start hitting big numbers right now. The Huybrechts,
he's really 99. Going for it here, is Kim Huybrechts. When he went 8-6 down, that 90 finish from Alan Norris, he has kept his cool.
Had every chance after that first dart, didn't he? It was lying beautifully with almost inviting more trebles into that 20 bed.
Slip there.
41.
Not the best visit, but still quite a bit ahead.
A little bit of twitchiness, maybe. Not on a finish yet, Huybrechts. And Norris is up, snarling at his heels now.
Well, all of a sudden, it's a close leg.
Bit of tension in the throw, maybe.
41.
Eyes on the line. Is it a bit of a Devon Lock moment as Norris continues to pile on the pressure?
133.
Great darts from Norris. But this. Oh!
To keep the match alive now. He's surely got to get this. Alan Norris, 54. There's the 14 for tops. In it goes, and we go down to the decider. A wry smile from Kim Huybrechts. The touch of fists. And now it really is, who blinks?
Well, you've got to take your hat off to Alan Norris. Huybrechts started the leg with a maximum. He'd just taken the last three legs. It looked like he was all over.
What a good game. And continuing right up to the line. And Norris gets a maximum. A brilliant time to achieve it.
What a turnaround. What a turnaround for Alan Norris.
140.
Good reply.
Norris still with the advantage of the throw. He'd still be the man who you'd pick from here in. Is it going to be another one? It is! Two maximums for Alan Norris.
Oh, shut the front door! Here we go.
137.
Well, what a way this would be to win a match. 141 for Alan Norris. No, just dragging it south of that bottom line. Pantomime boos 55. From the crowd. But a great effort from Alan Norris and a great reception from the crowd.
Big concentration levels needed here for Norris because the situation is both players are on a two-dart finish for a place in the semi-finals. What a last leg.
He's got to steady the heart rate. Calm down. That's a loose one. Treble 15 would have left tops, and Norris has made an absolute hash of that. So Huybrechts now can win the match.
Can he do it? 14 for the ball. The tension. He needs the ball.
45.
Goodness me. Nerves jangling. Look at the two players. Crowd is loving it. The lads are just trying to set themselves. Norris now with 60. That's the big 20. Two at tops for the match. Yes, he's done it! Alan Norris is into the last four. What a good game. Played in a lovely spirit. And Alan Norris, his nerve held at the final moments. Great effort from Kim Huybrechts. Those 10 maximums that he hit. Power scoring. But in the end, it was the big man, Alan Norris, who gets across the line and wins by the narrowest of margins. And rightfully, they get tremendous applause from the crowd. It's Alan Norris 10, Kim Huybrechts 9. Good match.
Chuck Norris coming out on top. It was an epic tussle. On the decider, he won it against Belgium's Kim Huybrechts to reach his first major PDC semi-final. Well, neither player will probably care too much about the stats, but any other people watching will do. Similar averages, Kim marginally higher with 98, hitting 10 180s to Alan 6. Norris missed 21 darts at double, but he's into tonight's semi-finals, and he and Kim will reflect on that match now with Ned Bolting.
No stress.
What a game it was. The boys are just unpicking it there, looking at their own statistics, and both of them quite rightly saying it wasn't much between you really on any of the counts, but someone's got to win, Kim, and it could have been you, but Alan just at the last, did you?
Yeah, indeed. It was a close game. I think the statistics say it for themselves. We was quite close. But to be fair, Alan let me in a couple of times in the beginning of the game. I missed some doubles. I did in the end 9-8 up, I think, and then I went 180 and then 241 scores, and I think that cost me the game in the end.
8-6 up, and then he comes back at you, 9-8, and then you've got to find it to turn it around again and give yourself a chance. That must some effort of concentration there, Alan.
Yeah, just a little bit. The crowd are going, they're having a good time, and me and Kim, we've had some battles in the past. He usually beats me on stage, to be honest. So, like you said, early doors, I missed a few doubles. I got the 160 when he was on a double, which I think that was for 3-2 at the break.
Yeah.
But, yeah, he paid me back with interest on that later on. Yeah, he's broke me 8-all. I'm 9-8 down. He's gone off 180, 140, the 241s afterwards, wasn't it? It was just, I thought, yeah, got to hit a 9 to beat the guy.
Yeah.
I broke him back. Oh, first 6 were all right. And then, went on holiday. But we are at Butlins.
Went on holiday. That decider, I mean, what a nail-biter that was. I think you were on 84, you were on 86. You started, it could have been a 9 dart, I mean, let's not forget that, but then from 86, you somehow contrived to make a mess of the next 3 darts, and that must have opened the door to Kim.
Well, I don't know, I usually go single 1, triple 15 tops, but yeah, it didn't really pan out, so yeah, I was absolutely nowhere near, you know. Yeah, you're a bundle of nerves up there, the crowd are going wild, they're enjoying the game, and I think me and Kim put on a great show for them, so.
Indeed, many, many congratulations, brilliant. Kim, just a final word from you. I mean, you just said, just before we did this interview, to Alan, go and win it now. I mean, you'd obviously like to see Alan win it. Can he do it? Has he got the game?
Of course he's got the game. He's a brilliant player. He's won a couple of titles in the last, last year and a half. He's doing really well. He's got the bottle. He's got the mindset. So, yeah, I think he's got a big chance to win this.
Brilliant from both of you. Sorry, one of you had to lose. Well done, Alan. Cheers.
Thank you.
Yeah, well done, Alan Norris. He was a 66-1 outsider at the start of the tournament, but he is now into the last 4. On to our second quarter-final, which pits Stokes' Ian White, who's kind of had his business very quietly but effectively this weekend, up against the Welshman Gerwyn Price. He put an end to Paul Hogan's inspired run last night. Both men have been talking to Ned.
Well, Ian and Gerwyn, this is going to be a really good encounter, isn't it? I don't know if you never get a chance during tournaments to watch each other play on other boards, but you're both in fine fettle, aren't you? Good darts from you yesterday, Gerwyn.
Yeah, about time I put a performance in on the big stage, but you know, it was a different day today, so hopefully I can just back that up. But like I said, I haven't seen Ian play this weekend, but I'm sure he's played well to get to this stage, so it's going to be a great game.
Yeah, I spoke to you yesterday and you said you quite like living in the shadows a little bit, under the rock, and no one really taking too much notice. They're going to take notice now, aren't they?
Well, I think so. You know, it's back to the quarterfinals again now, so, you know, it's a good opportunity for me and Gerwyn, you know, to get to the semi-final. But yeah, playing well all weekend, under the radar. You know, you can keep talking about all the ones that lads are hitting 105 averages. You know, just leave me alone, I'm okay.
Yeah, you say it's a good opportunity for both of you, actually, progressing to the semi-final of the UK Open. Pretty much as good as it gets so far in your careers.
Oh, definitely, yeah. You know, we all want the World Championships and match play, but this UK Open, you know, it's just as good as any of the others. And, yeah, we both want to get there. In fact, we both want to win it within that stage now, within the last 8.
Yeah.
You know, one of us could win it. And me and Gerwyn, you know, we've got a good chance.
You've not been at this point so deep into a tournament yet, Gerwyn. I'm sure there'll be many more to come. Does it feel different now going into a Sunday with, as Ian says, a genuine chance of winning this tournament?
Yeah, I've been there once. I played a quarter final in the match play. That's about it. But in TV events, it's quite difficult. You know, I'm the early exit all the time. You know, Ian's on about the big tournaments like the Worlds, about doing well in those. I'd just be happy to win one game in that, to be honest. You know, I'm out first round every year. But you know, I'm in the quarters. I've got a good chance. So is Ian, and so is the other 6 players.
Too close to call, probably. I don't know what the bookies are making it, but I'm looking forward to watching you both. Good luck to you both.
Thank you very much.
Cheers.
Well, this one has got the makings of a really tight one, but the bar was set very high.